Hello children, today we will study test 1 of your English 1 book. So you all open page number 45. So children, in test 1 there are questions given which has covered all your term 1 and term 2 portion. Okay, so it is a kind of revision you will have. Okay, so we will see the exercises. I'll take a quick recap of whatever topic is covered, and likewise we will do the exercises. So test 1. So first question is, pick out the nouns from which the following sentences and say whether they are proper or common. So children, if you remember, in first term we studied about noun. So do you remember what is a noun? Naming word is called a noun. Okay, the name given to any person, place or thing is called a noun. So now, proper or common, we also studied proper and common noun. What is a proper noun, children? A proper noun, a noun which is a special name, that is the name of a particular person, place or thing, is a proper noun. Okay, this is a special name given to any particular person, place or thing. And remember, proper noun always starts with capital letter. Okay, and common noun, what is a common noun? Common noun, it is a general name for the same kind of things or persons or places. Okay, that is known as a common noun. Means common noun does not refer to any particular person, place or thing. It is the name given in general. So this is proper or common noun. So I hope you remember now. So let's do the exercise part now. He went to the dentist last Thursday. Okay, now see, he is a pronoun, leave it. Went is a verb, leave it. Come to this dentist. Okay, dentist means what? The doctor who checks your teeth and all, huh? That doctor is known as dentist. Now here, dentist, there is no any particular name given to the dentist. Okay, means if I say you go to the dentist and have your teeth got check up. Okay, if I say this, so dentist, you can go to any dentist. I'm not talking about any particular dentist. So dentist is a common noun. Okay, now see Thursday. So Thursday comes only once in a week. There is no two or three or four Thursdays in a week. There's only one Thursday in a week. So it is a particular day, a definite day I'm talking about. So Thursday is a proper noun, and see, Thursday starting with capital T. Okay, let's see the second sentence. The Qutub Minar is in Delhi and the Dal Lake is in Kashmir. Now see, Qutub Minar, it is a name of a particular monument or building, you can say. Okay, there is only one Qutub Minar. There are no 2, 3, 4, 5 Qutub Minars in a country or in the world. There is only one Qutub Minar. So unique things are proper noun. Okay, it is a particular name which is given to a monument. So Qutub Minar is a proper noun. Now Delhi. Delhi is also a particular, a special name given to a city. So it is also a proper noun. Dal Lake. Okay, if suppose there is, dal is not there. Okay, suppose I hide the word dal, huh, and only lake is there. So then lake can be any lake. Okay, but it is not any lake. If the name is given Dal Lake, if I say go and see the Dal Lake, then you will not see any other lake. You will see only the Dal Lake. So it is a special name given to the lake. So Dal Lake is also proper noun. Okay, and Kashmir, it is also a special name given to a place. So it is a proper noun. So see, Qutub Minar, Delhi, Dal Lake, Kashmir, all are proper noun, and you can see that all are written with capital letter. Okay, now here, if I said Dal is not there, only lake is there, then you will not write lake with capital letter, it will be with small letter. okay, then it would be common noun. But because it is associated, it is in combination with this dull lake, so we take it as one name. So it is a proper noun, both dull as well as lake. Zan went to the shop down the street to buy some butter. Okay, till here. So Zan is the name of a boy. So of course it is a proper noun. We know this. Shop. Now shop, it's not written which shop, any shop. Okay. So and street, again there is no any particular name given to the street. So it can be any street. Butter, there is no special name given to the butter, Amul butter or something like that, just butter. So shop, street and butter. Shop, street, butter, all will be common noun. Okay. The kitten played with a ball of wool. Now kitten, any kitten, no special name given. So kitten is a common noun. Ball, it can be any ball. Wool, any wool. So all kitten, ball, wool, there is no special name given, so all are common noun. Cinderella sat by the fire and thought about the grand party at the palace. Now Cinderella, it is a special name given to a girl. You all know, you all have heard the story of Cinderella, and it is very much liked by children also. So Cinderella is the special name given to a girl. So Cinderella is a proper noun. Fire. Fire is common noun. There is no special name given to it. Then party. Party is also can be any party. No special name given. Palace. Palace can be any palace. So fire, party and palace, they are common noun. Okay. Next is Varun fed the goldfish in the tank. Varun, it is a special name of a boy. So Varun is a proper noun. Goldfish. Goldfish is not a special name given to a fish. It is a kind of fish. Okay. It is a variety of fish, you can say. So goldfish is a common noun. And means there can be many goldfish. It is not just only one goldfish. And tank. Tank can be any tank. So goldfish, tank, both are common noun. Okay, don't think that it is a special name given to a fish, so it should be proper noun. No, goldfish, it is just a kind of fish. Leo wanted some money to buy a little rabbit for a pet. Leo is the name of a person, so Leo is a proper noun. Money, money means, okay, money in general we are talking about. Rabbit can be any rabbit. Pet can be any pet. So money, rabbit, pet, all are common noun. Okay, so I hope you have understood how to pick out proper and common noun. Now let's see the next one. Underline the adjectives in the following sentences. So adjective, what are adjectives, children? You remember? Describing words are called adjectives. Okay. Or we can say the words which describe noun or pronoun are called adjectives. Now let's see. The giant had a big feet and needed large shoes. Now see, giant is a noun. Okay. But which kind of giant, we don't know. So leave it. Now feet is a noun. Now, which kind of feet? We get the answer, big feet. Okay. So, this word big is describing the noun feet. So, this big is an adjective. And needed large shoes. We know that shoes is a noun. Okay. Common noun. We know that. Now, which kind of shoes? Large shoes. So, this word large is describing the noun shoes. And we know the words which describes noun are called adjectives. Okay. So large is also adjective. So I hope you've understood what is an adjective. Saima was happy because she had got a new computer. Now Saima is a noun, proper noun. We know that. So how was Saima? Saima was happy. Who was happy? Saima was happy. So this word happy is describing whom? This word happy is describing the noun Saima. So this is a describing word, so it is an adjective, because describing words are called adjective. So happy is also adjective. Because she got a new computer. Now computer is also a noun, common noun. Which kind of computer? New computer. This new is describing the noun computer. So new is also adjective. Okay, so happy and new, both are adjective. Let's turn the page. Okay, now see here. We had a sweet dish made of fresh fruits and creamy custard. Now, dish is a noun. Okay, which kind of dish? Sweet dish. So this word sweet is describing the noun dish. So sweet is adjective. Fruits. Fruits is also a noun, common noun. Which kind of fruits? Fresh fruits. So this fresh is describing the noun fruits. So fresh is also an adjective. Creamy custard. Which kind of custard? Creamy custard. Custard is a noun, and this word creamy is describing the noun. So this word will be adjective. Okay. So sweet, fresh, creamy. They are all adjectives. The poor woodcutter had to feed his hungry children. Now woodcutter is a noun, common noun. Which kind of woodcutter? Poor woodcutter. Okay. So this word poor is describing the noun woodcutter. So poor is an adjective. Children. Children is a common noun. Which kind of children? Hungry children. Okay. So hungry is describing the noun children. So hungry is an adjective. The little kitten looked up with its shiny round eyes. Okay. Kitten. Kitten is a common noun. Which kind of kitten? Little kitten. So this little is describing the noun kitten. So little is an adjective. Now eyes. Eyes is also noun, common noun. Which kind of eyes? Shiny round eyes. So here two words are describing this noun eyes. Okay. So both are adjective. Shiny also and round also. So in this sentence, little, shiny, round, all are adjectives. The huge troll had long arms and a funny small head on his short neck. Now, which kind of troll? Troll means, children, giant. Okay, you can say giant. So the huge giant or the huge troll had long arms and a funny small head on his short neck. Okay, so which kind of troll? Huge troll. So this word huge is described, so troll is a noun, we can say, no? So now, because it's a name given to it's a name of a giant, you can say, so it is a common noun. So which kind of troll? Huge troll. So huge is describing the noun troll, so it is an adjective. Now arms. Arms is a common noun. Which kind of arms? Long arms. So long is describing the noun arms. So long is adjective. Now head. Head is a noun. Which kind of head? Funny, small head. It is a funny head, small head. So both the words are describing the noun head. So funny as well as small, both are adjectives. Okay. Now neck. Which kind of neck? Short neck. So short is describing the noun neck. So short is also adjective. So in this sentence, we see how many adjectives? Huge, long, funny, small, short. These are all adjectives because they are describing the nouns. Neck, troll, arms, head. Okay. Seventh one. Rai is a shy girl with a beautiful voice. Now girl. Girl is a noun. Which kind of girl? Rai is shy girl. Okay, so this word shy is describing the noun girl. So shy is an adjective. Voice is also a noun. So which kind of voice? Beautiful voice. So beautiful is describing the noun voice. So beautiful is also adjective. So in this sentence, shy and beautiful are adjectives. Okay, so I hope children you have understood how to pick adjectives, and we'll do till here only, and next video we will do the next exercise. So I want you all to fill your exercise book till here. Okay, thank you.